welcome back to EA Sports. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, to bring you this NHL Eastern Conference Showdown. Opening faceoff is set to go. Referee Gilles Levesque is ready to drop the puck. The Flyers take possession here on the opening draw. We are underway. Moves it to Kreider. And now he tries to get it across to Fox. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Lundgren. His reflexes on display tonight. Oh, we'll get some tired defenders as icing is the call.
Couturier is usually scouted before any key matchup because he's a special player and a good point getter. Fox is known for his accurate passing plays. That's his tape-to-tape zone ability, guys, and it's what makes him effective at distributing the puck. I'm expecting one of these two players to get their team the edge tonight, guys. Back to you.
Couturier, Scott, in his own zone. And they get the puck out of the defensive end. And they'll dump it in. New York's got possession of the puck. Slides the puck across to Matrano. Now here inside his own territory. Quick feed to Lundgren. The Rangers move it ahead. New York's got the puck against the board. Quick pass to Fox. Takes the pass. The Rangers glide it along the line. And he slides it quickly to Lundgren.
Job for you.
get on the power play for the first time this evening. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. And he hangs on just as time runs out. And with that, the first period comes to an end. Both teams will have a chance to get a breather, and they'll be back on the ice for period number two in not too long.
Can seep away when your guy doesn't do so well in the fight.
Yeah, you can hear a pin drop in this arena now. Both teams had a chance for a little reset as they step in for the faceoff. along with Ray Ferraro. My name is James Simone. Welcome back to the Sports, continuing coverage of the National Hockey League. Eastern Conference Showdown, East Side, West Side, let's go. Enough talk, enough hype, let's do this. Your first period is set to go. Oh, I've been waiting for this all game. We are now officially underway. There's the whistle, offside is the call. Lots of time left in this period. Still scoreless in this one. Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Fires it into the offensive zone. Takes the pass and banks it off the wall. Frost's exploring options with the puck. And there's the save. Colorado's got a hold of the puck. Great pressure to force the turnover. Just moments away, it's our first opportunity to look at the power play unit here.
You never know when your opportunities are going to show up here to tie the game. Well, I don't know if the power play can be any bigger of a chance than that.
Here's the clearing attempt, and the puck's out of harm's way. Puck grabbed by the block. There's an attack with a stick, and the referees don't like it. Let's get the official decision.
That's another penalty, three in the period. On the offensive, players are licking their chops here. This is a long 5-on-3. The potential to do damage is sitting right in front of them. Saves in a row.
Now he takes it over the line. Hayes has the puck against the half wall. Shots on the wall. And he comes up with the save. Taken by Frost. The Avs will try to shave a few seconds off this penalty now. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. Lehkonen's going to join the penalty kill here as they remain short-handed. Colorado's got him in their own zone.
Compher's up at the box.
The Flyers are still on a goal after the power play comes up empty.
You work so hard to get yourself back in the game, you earn a power play, and then you fail to cash in. So they still trail by one. The game will continue at even strength.
The Avs will play it in their own end. Colorado's down against the boards. Shot! Oh, and there goes Armstrong's mask. I don't think he planned to stop it that way, but he keeps it out.
Looked like he didn't pick that puck up really early, and he reacted late, but he gets it right off the top of the mask. That one's going to sting.
Hayes wins possession of the defensive zone. Puck scooped up by Van Riemsdyk. Grabbed along the board by Ristolainen. And now it's grabbed by Sanheim. Puck picked up by Van Riemsdyk.
And we'll get a face-off after the offside call.
Teams are lined up, and we are ready to take this draw. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Puts the bow on the first 20 minutes of play. We've got lots more still to come. Second period action next, right here. Continue to try to kill off this penalty. Colorado's won it. Quick feed to Rantanen. Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. Looks like there's a delayed penalty being called here by the officials. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
You can actually gain a little momentum here if the penalty killers do the job. Down a goal, if they kill this, you're going to have some jump.
Philadelphia's got it in the defensive zone. Taken by Sanheim. And the puck clears the zone. Looking to break out here on the power play. Nice zone entry
The abs carried along the wall. And reads the play perfectly and picks off the pass.
The Flyers have stolen a bunch of pucks tonight, and a couple of games in a close game, this easily could be the difference.
The abs getting nothing here on this power play. We're back to even strength.
Too passive, not aggressive enough. The puck gets moved around the outside of the penalty killers. Really doesn't become a dangerous power play.
The Avs gain control of the puck. Here inside the offensive end, takes the feed from along the boards. Scooped up along the wall by Hayes. Nice job to escape the zone. That's a textbook save by Kemper. Makar's taking it from his own end.
Increasing their lead to two.
Third period next. And we are just moments away from the start of the third period. Red Corral is back down.
Abs have it behind the cage. Moves it quickly over to McCarr. Maintains control of the puck. Taves has it in the defensive end. Colorado's got it in the offensive zone. Great reach with the hook check.
Friends, welcome back to EA Sports. Beautiful night for hockey. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's get it going tonight. Both teams lined up in the middle. We are ready to get things underway. Puck is dropped. Let's do this hockey. Looking to make something happen here in the corner. An easy save by Campbell. The Leafs gain possession along the wall. They try to maintain possession inside the defensive zone. The call, big face-off looming. We're still in the early stages of this period. Still no score in this one. Toronto's down in the offensive zone.
That was an important face-off, James. Now they got an offensive zone possession.
Dumps it into the other end.
Victoria is known for doing his best work in the defensive zone. Guys, his stick-em-up zone ability, it's what allows him to make great use of his stick checking to defend in his own end of the ice.
Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Lindblom's got it in the defensive end. Dumped into the opposite corner. Moves it to Riley. Directs it on over to
okay.
The Leafs played along the boards. Quick feed to Nylander. Here's a shot. What save. And now it's grabbed by Provorov. Poked away in the offensive end. Toronto's down the puck. Big save by the goaltender watching that one.
I like how he was able to follow the puck. Good saving close.
Nearing the midway mark of the period. The game is still scoreless. Nice job tying up his opponent. Next into the defensive zone. Poked up ahead after a nice pass to the right wing. The Leafs get a hold of the puck in their own end. That's bluffed by Campbell. Dishes up to Kirkwood. The Flyers going to work on offense.
Nice move by the goalie to get out close to the shooter.
Centers get set as they're ready to drop the puck again. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Nice pass. Kasha's carrying it ahead. Tries to squeeze on.
That's defended perfectly.
Yandel's stick handling in his own zone. Puck picked up by McEwen. And that's knocked away. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. And now he tries to get it across to Frost. Trying to get 2-2 with it and loses possession.
Frost got lots of tricks on the sleeve, but he tries there to get around the defender. Just can't quite complete the move.
Puck grabbed by Giordano. Call, we'll get a face up at the other end. Past the midway mark of the frame, still looking for our first goal. Couturier's won the draw here in the offensive zone. And he gets in the lane to block that. And he makes the save on that play. It's a 2-on-1 rush. The pass.
move almost anywhere. The coaches have great faith in his ability, but he just can't complete it.
There's the horn. Still 40 more minutes left in regulation time. We'll get to the second period right after this. With a chance to recharge and refresh in this second period, about set to get underway. Still a slow pass, but we'll see if period number two finds ourselves a goal. One period already in the books. Ray, how have you seen this thing?
The Leafs coaches would have told their players, play the same way. We had the puck pull up. I know the game's scoring, but we're doing everything right.
Toronto's game possession.
Yeah, it got heated up pretty quickly. Hayes is trying to drop the mitts here. He just can't get anyone to fight him.
The Flyers win the faceoff. Slides it over to Ristolainen. And they get the puck out of the danger zone. Ben Riemsdyk's got the puck in his own zone. And that doesn't exactly go 10-2. Trying to get it out of the road end. period. We're still scoreless. Toronto's got it, and they're on the attack. And now it's over to Spezza. Nice punch kick inside the attacking zone. Finally coming up, and they clear the puck. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
Oh, he took way too long to run there on that hit. That's a boarding penalty. Scoreless game, power play gets their first opportunity. Man, I couldn't get on the ice quick enough for these, James.
The Leafs move the puck in the defensive zone. And now it's to Kemp. Turns it over. The Leafs have the puck now. And no luck on that pass attempt.
And I guess at times it looked dangerous, but just nothing really going on the power play. They let that one slip through their fingers.
Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck. While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck. And the traffic jamming front blocks the shot. And a strong effort on that play. Been a great night of hockey here on EA Sports, and we got the third period coming at you in moments. I'm James Cebulski, ready to bring you period number three. Still scoreless as we are now underway in the third. He tries to make a chance to pass to Hunter. And that's intercepted at the defensive end. Picked up along the wall, but he clearly doesn't like that. Slides the puck. Some pushing and shoving here, heating up.
Yeah, the few words lead to a little bit more, it looks like. York's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else.
Officials finally starting to get control here. It looks like both sides are going to the box.
At the risk of throwing too many people in the box, they just throw one from each side. Even things out to try and get this game back on track.
And on the heels of that call, we get ourselves a little 4-on-4 on the ice.
4-on-4 is all about getting a 2-on-1 somewhere on the ice. Use that extra speed to your advantage.
Broken up with a stick at the defensive end. Taken by Frost. And they send it down the ice. Scooped up along the wall by Atkinson. Quick feed to Frost. Gets the puck in deep. And now it's caught by Atkinson. Stays with it. Ferriby's got it along the wall.
scorer's goal right there. That puck is on and off his stick in a hurry. He's so tight to the net, he has to get rid of it before the goalie can readjust.
They take possession as he locks him up on the back. Here in the late stages of this frame, the Leafs have taken a 1-0 lead. Steps in and takes the puck. Toronto's got it now. And that's turned aside.
Puck's locked in. Every puck hits him and stays in front of him. And the odd chance there's a rebound, he tracks that well too.
Officials are in position and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another faceoff here. Couturier's won it. Ellis takes the puck. Taken by Couturier. And he easily stops that one.
Yeah, it did, James. You can hear that funny sound when the puck hit his mask. It doesn't sound like the post. It's not a stick.
He shakes the puck. He's calling him out now. Tension's rising.
Didn't take much to get this heated up. Couturier's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
Well, it's going to be a couple of penalties called on this play, James. Offsetting penalties. No power plays will result.
Marner's hockey IQ is among the league's best, guys. We know that. And he uses his deceptive and difficult passes to set up his teammates for the most success. That's his third awesome ability, and that's how he contributes to this club.
And he regains control of the puck. That pops out of the offensive zone. They'll be forced to do it over from center. Puck is dropped. Play resumes. Gets it over to Nylander. Can't connect on the pass. The Flyers have it now. Looking for space inside the D zone. Across the line from center. And that's intercepted by Ruby. Riley's got it into offensive territory. Puck scooped up by Tavares. Knocked away in the offensive zone. There's the whistle. We've got an offside. Some last-second communication with the D as centers get ready to drop the puck. He's calling him out.
Did he ever? This is going to get heated.
Locks him up on the draw as they take possession. And he loses possession of the puck after trying to make one too many moves.
Giordano's trying to change this game all by himself. That's not going to work. I don't fault the effort. It's just simple. It's sometimes a lot better.
And there's the final horn. Say the goaltender that gets the hottest of the playoffs is usually the team that wins it. Boy, don't want to peek too soon, but this is impressive, Ray.
Yeah, I noticed you didn't say anything about it during the last couple minutes because you were worried about the jinx. There is no jinx. You're 150 feet away from the net. He played fantastic.
Conference and Western Conference hostilities are renewed on the ice tonight. Hi, everybody. I'm James Cebulski, along with Ray Ferraro for EA Sports, continuing coverage of the NHL. We are just seconds away now from puck drop. The Flyers take possession here on the opening draw, and we are underway. Oh, we'll get some tired defenders as icing is the call. Lots of time left in this period. Still scoreless in this one. And they take possession. Nice job tangling him up on the draw. Moves it to Couturier. Minnesota's got it in their own zone. They've got numbers here. The Flyers get a hold of the puck along the boards. Minnesota's got it along the wall. And it's a quick pass to Spurgeon. Away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Came up with the save on that play. Stops him again. No way, the official signal and a goal. That's a goal.
Wow, did he hammer that? Too much power for the goalie to control, and it hits him and still goes in.
Philadelphia has made their way back to center ice here, and they've got that 1-0 lead.
The road is a funny place to play. You can't really be too aggressive, but when you get an early lead, James, you can open it up a little bit.
Point-to-point pass. Ref's arms in the air. We got a penalty coming up. Goaltender scores!
When you're on the ice for a delayed penalty offensively, you have no worry at home taking a chance. Nothing bad. Shot is a good one. It's released quickly, but the goaltender never picks it up. There's such a gaggle of traffic in front of him. He never finds the puck, let alone the shooter.
Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Great pressure on the offensive end by Fiala. Looking to get it out.
From there.
Wonder if that gives him a nightmare later. Makes a move and the puck hops away from him.
You can sure tell when a player starts to press. Holds onto the puck just a little bit too long, tries a play that really isn't there.
Cuts into the paint. Nothing doing. Oh, snow heads up play. From the top of the offensive zone here. Minnesota's got a hold of the puck now. Control the puck along the wall. Trying to clear. And they get the job done. Minnesota's got possession of the puck. Breaks up the play with a poke check. And there's the whistle icing the call.
Needs to produce night in and night out.
Swoops in.
of the frame. James and Ray with you tonight. We got a tie game. Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Turn that chance aside.
Good save. Positional save through trap.
Picked up along the wall by Couturier. Quick feed to Spurgeon. Slides the puck over. And now he moves it quickly to Goligoski. Poked away in the offensive zone by Hartman. Minnesota's trying to make something happen in the offensive zone. Here he is. He scores! They take the lead!
Well, it looked like this game was going to be even for the longest time because nobody seems to have the upper hand. I don't think the goaltender gets a look at this at all, James. He just drops into the butterfly. He's hoping the thing hits him through that traffic.
Minnesota's effort pays off. They've taken a one-goal lead.
Deserved one-goal lead, too, James. I think they played quite well, but now you've got a little bit of an opening trying to stretch the lead.
And that's picked off in the neutral zone by Ristolainen.
The Flyers have continually put themselves in good positions defensively tonight. It seems like every shift they're stealing the puck.
Minnesota's got the puck in the defensive end. And here's a pass to Jost.
We'll get to the second period right after both teams get a chance to catch their breath. Stick around.
Hey fans, if you're getting your season tickets now with this year's playoff locations and prices, you need the regular season ticket price for rounds 1 through 3. That offer is available now. Don't miss your opportunity to get the best location for next season. Stop by section 144 on the golf course.
Ray, this looked like a mistake, and it clearly was.
It looked like he was fighting in a bag. He had no chance in this fight. Things got pretty quiet here, but the decision was pretty clearly to the road team.
Both teams had a chance for a little reset as they step in for the faceoff. Along the boards. something happen along the boards.
Into the corner now. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Picked up along the boards by Zuccarello. Philadelphia's got the puck. Scooped up along the wall by Victoria. Scoops up the puck here. Now the heels of that big hit. He's being called out. Buckle up, they're gonna drop the gloves.
Yeah, he jumped in pretty quick, didn't he? He's not gonna let him fight. To sit for 5 minutes. I hope he can get a drink of water. Lots of in there. The bottle was empty, which really must stink. You know, you're tired and thirsty, and now you get a bowl of dust.
You don't miss a thing, do you?
I never was in there.
Yeah, I was in there. I hated when the bottle was
empty. And there's a chance.
Oh, he didn't have enough gas to get the shot off. Really good work by the defender to close the gap. In a good defensive posture. That's being on top of you. There's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
We got a stoppage. Let's get the call. The Wilds have been called for tripping on the play. The Flyers could really open things up with a 5-on-3 power play.
5-on-3 can be a great advantage, but it'll sometimes go south if the offensive players aren't very aggressive getting the puck to the net.
And now he moves it to Spurgeon. To the low slot. Oh, look at this. Makes the save.
He's in the bumper position in the middle of the slot. They move the puck around and find him in the middle, and he makes no mistake.
The Flyers have narrowed the gap here late in this second period. Some momentum for them now.
Now they want to close this period off well, get themselves into the third with a chance to get back into it.
Still to come. Third period action right after we get a clean sheet of ice. Are set, officials are set, third period action is coming up. Centers ready to take the draw here coming up. Good read by the winger as the two centers tie up. Puck sent over to Yandel. Nice job to escape the zone. Spurgeon's got the puck. Strong defensive effort. The midway mark. Minnesota's doubled up on them. It's now 4-2. Oh, coming on too high!
He doesn't miss by much, James, but that's not even a shot on goal.
And that's intercepted by Fiala. Puck scooped up by Eriksson Ek. Taken by Dumba. And now he tries to get it across to Eriksson Ek. Single stop by Hart.
keeps hold of the puck. Maintains possession. And the puck leaves the zone. Play is called for offside. More than half the period has expired. Lots of offense here tonight. 4-2 is where we're sitting. Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. And serves up a little knock on the play. Moves the puck behind the net. Dumba's taking it from his own end. Good battle along the boards for the puck. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. And he moves it up to Foligno. Oh, had a chance to make a nice move, and the puck disagreed with him.
Foligno's close to pulling off a great move there. Just denied in zone.
There's the whistle. We got an offside. Here in the late going to the frame. 4-2 is the score. Hayes wins it. And that pass attempt is deflected. He's looking for a dance partner.
Yeah, he looks like he wants.
They're going to go here.
This isn't about winning the game anymore. This is about settling a score.
This is always the danger in a fight. You get into it, and if you get tagged, it's gonna hurt. He looks like he's really struggling here.
Action set to resume here after what was a wild couple of minutes on the ice there. And a good read to get possession there with the two centermen tangled up. Minnesota's got possession at center. The Flyers have it from their own end. The Wild have gained control of the puck along the wall. The Flyers take over on possession. They get it out of the defensive end. He's got a step. Oh, what a stop by the goaltender.
He makes an excellent stop. One-on-one with the shooter. He follows him nicely to make the stop.
Huge. Puck picked up by Zuccarello. Takes it to the net. Broken up with the stick in the defensive zone. Gets the puck over to Atkinson. Moves it to Golodowski. And we've got an offside with a face-off looming. Late goings of this period. We've got ourselves a 4-2 hockey game. While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck.
Just watch the puck and accept the icing. He keeps it alive and they'll continue the shift.
Puck possession so critical. Another faceoff coming up here. And with the two centers tangled up, the winger skates away with it. And that's cut away in the offensive zone by Goudreau. The Flyers take possession in the defensive end. Into the corner. Philadelphia's grab a hold of the puck. Quick feed to Sanheim. And a stick breaks out of him. And this one is all over as the final horn sounds.
If you can control the puck, you control the pace of the game. And I thought that had a lot to do, James, with the way this turned out. They seemed to have the puck locked.
Did it also seem like the ice is maybe tilted in this one tonight?
Well, if it is, then the engineer's got to fix it because you can't have an uneven ice.
Welcome, everybody, along with Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski to this EA Sports Showdown, and we are fired up. Let's drop the puck already. Centers are lined up, official ready to drop the puck.
Judges. Of course, everybody jumps up when the fight happens, but your guy wins, and the building just keeps moving along.
And the crowd's still on their feet here, Ray. Face-off coming up here, and this crowd and stirring the pot.
A little friction, and all of a sudden, guys are getting heated.
The Flyers get a hold of the puck off the draw. Intercepted in the offensive end by Kulchek. How did he stop that one?
In tight end to make an excellent save.
And now it's over to Van Riemsdyk. Can't get it to go. Taken along the wall by Yandel. Puck grabbed by Frost. Yandel's taking it from his own end. And they get the puck out. The Hurricanes will take it from the back of the net. Pesci's got it in the defensive end. Gains the zone from the right. On the attack along the boards. Centering pass. Oh, Ray, he's going to walk that one back.
You bet. Right in the middle of the ice, and he fires it over top of the goal.
And they get the puck out of the danger zone. Grabbed along the boards by Pesci. Puck said down the ice. We'll get an icing. Still lots of time left in the period. We've still got zeros on the board. Great read by the Ray to take possession with the two centermen tied up. Hammers one. Big time stop. Right on the doorstep. Oh, another save. Driving right to the front. There's another stop.
I love the way that he's in position, and he's got the reflexes to bang out a couple of stops in a row.
Victoria is known for great stick checking in his own end, guys. He's got that stick-em-up zone ability, and that's his puck checking skills that he uses to fend off an attack.
Locks them up on the draw as they take possession. Here's the clearing attempt. They get it done. Hangs onto the puck. And that's a smart heads-up play by Kovalev. And he's going after him here. Oh, against. You can't do that to the Stars.
Yeah, even if you think it's a clean hit, I do. It doesn't matter. Somebody's coming after you.
Down he goes, fairly one-sided, would you say?
Yeah, I've been on the other side of that one side, and you're happy when it goes down to the ice, because you know help is on the way.
Story of my life in elementary school, Ray.
Not much to be said from the home team here. Their bench kind of quietly sits back down after their guy comes on the losing end of this bout.
Yeah, the air from this building seems to have just deflated in here. Offense is on face-off, and he wins the draw. Quick to take the pass. Sends the pass over. Puck sails out of the bench, sending a few people ducking. Past the halfway mark of this period, the game is still scoreless. They take possession as he locks them up off the face-off. And that one's broken up. Quick pass to Van Riemsdyk. Comes to the cross side. The Hurricanes gain control of the puck against the wall. Turns all over the rebound and tucks it in for the goal.
Get to the net. That's where the goals are. The rebound sits there and he puts it away.
Game's first goal.
You work for the opportunity to get a chance on goal. Now they get it and they're able to capitalize.
Fires it into the offensive zone. Moves it quickly over to Trochek. Philadelphia's got hold of the puck now. He was totally locked in on that play.
You can see the frustration growing as the period goes along.
The Hurricanes get their man advantage unit out there for the first time tonight.
They've been working hard looking for the equalizer. What a chance here on the power play.
The Hurricanes win the draw. Hurricanes played along the boards. Gets a piece of it with the glove.
He's going to go back to the bench and want to look at that one again. He had enough time.
Break away. But he can't get it to go.
Looks like an overthink to me, James. You got three things in your head and you can't quite pick anything. And you end up with no shot on net.
Things starting to get a little physical out there.
Provorov's up and ready to join the play.
Here tonight, we've got lots more still to come. Second period is just around the corner.
Hey fans, don't forget to get the speech you want, the games you want by purchasing one of our skating ticket packets today.
Taking a 1-0 lead.
centermen glide into position. Aho's won the draw.
Well, now they've got them running around. They're a little tired out of the ice.
Takes control of the puck. The Flyers have it behind the net. Here's a clearing attempt from their own end. And they get it out. Play whistle dead, offside the call.
Have continually put themselves in good positions defensively tonight. It seems like every shift we're stealing the puck.
The Flyers have it now. And now it's grabbed by the team. And they clear the puck. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. The Flyers gain possession. And that's poked away by Ignatius. Oh, that's a huge stop by Hart.
I thought they worked the puck around pretty good. Here they get a good chance on goal, but not to be.
Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. The Flyers lead it 1-0. The Hurricanes win it. The Flyers gain control of it. Ellis puts the puck in his own zone. Philadelphia's got possession at center. And not much on that one.
Philadelphia's efforts have to be towards creating offense. He gets stopped there, but what he's supposed to do. The fight is in the past, and he doesn't need to be doing that very often.
And he passes up ahead to Moss. Quick shot! Comes up with a stop! Trying to get the puck out of harm's way. Taken by Ellis. Provorov's gaining momentum. And we'll get a fresh set of legs to the defensive pairing as the puck is sent into the offensive zone. The Hurricanes have it now. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Moss. Slides the puck to Ristolainen. First quarter dump in. Carolina's got the puck now. The Flyers will play from the defensive zone. Picked up along the wall by Farabee. The Flyers play the puck from the back of the net. On the play. And that banks off a stick. Shea swooping in on the attack. Cut scooped up by Allen. That goes wide.
Most dangerous play on the ice, and he can't capitalize.
There's another try from Perez. And the puck clears the zone. Here in the late stages of this frame, 1-0 the score. Lunds won the draw here in the offensive zone. And the puck skips out of the zone. They'll be forced to tag up. The Flyers playing along the boards. Second frame almost done. Well inside a minute now. And that's stalled, and they'll go on the attack. Wait. Ray. I'm James, and we are ready to kickstart this third period. Still in the early stages of this period. Philadelphia's up 1-0. And they take possession. Nice job tangling him up on the draw. Gains the zone through the middle. Here's a short pass to Jarvis. And a smart heads up Reed to come up with the puck. Picked up along the board by Slavin. Play as we get an offside. Nearing the midway mark of the period. Philadelphia's ahead 1-0. Center's jammed up and the winger grabs the puck. Sent into the offensive zone. Get into position. Sneaks away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Philadelphia's got it in their own zone. The Hurricanes gain possession of the puck here in the offensive end. Made the stop on that play.
No room for the shooter. The goaltender snuffed it out.
And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. And that was read perfectly. What a play by Pesci. Along the half wall with the puck. Great heads up play with the stick by Ellis. Carolina's gained possession along the boards. Manages to hang on.
From one end of the blue line.
that there's no need for a risky play.
There can only be one winner. Let's do this on the ice. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, ready for puck action. Both teams seem ready, and they are about to drop the puck in this opening faceoff. The Flyers take possession here on the opening draw, and we are underway. The last penalty coming up here. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
Didn't take long for the coach to start shaking his head. A penalty on the first shift of the game.
Philadelphia sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
Scoreless game. Power play gets their first opportunity. Man, I couldn't get on the ice quick enough for these, James.
And a solid job tying up his opponent. Nice job to escape the zone. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. Now into the offensive zone from the right side. Just a simple save by Quick.
Good technique as the puck is over to the corner out of the way.
Philadelphia's got a hold of it along the wall. It's gone over to Frost. Receives the pass. And the shot dies in the trap. National Hockey League action is on the agenda tonight, courtesy of EA Sports. Hi, everybody. I'm James Cebulski, along with Ray Ferraro, for this Interconference Showdown. Both teams are lined up, and we are set to get things going. Face-off coming up. Still plenty of time left in this frame. Still no score in this one. Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Oh, and that doesn't go well. The call will get a face-off at the other end. Inching closer to the midway mark of this period. Still scoreless in this one. Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. Official blows the play dead as the puck goes out of bounds. Centers glide into the dot as the faceoff ready to resume play. Great read by the way to take the from their own end.
official says here. The Avs are getting 2 minutes for tripping. Philadelphia's got a small window with a 5-on-3.
This 5-on-3 is critical, even though it's a short one. Get yourself set up and quickly get the puck to the net and move those defensemen around.
Johnson's got the puck in his own zone. Puck clear to the defensive end.
James, so the faceoff becomes even more critical. If you lose it, you chase it down the ice, and most of that 5-on-3 is gone.
To make something against a tired team.
Hart's gonna cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did.
Can they capitalize on this power play? Here comes the faceoff. Good job tangling up his opponent here. The Flyers are in transition. Stick around.
the opening faceoff here in period number two is about set. The Avs open up the period on a positive note, winning the draw, and have almost killed off this penalty. Tosses it to McCarr. Time's up on the power play. Both teams back even strength.
It's pretty hard to have a more low-intensity power play than that. It really didn't generate a thing, and when you don't generate much, you're sure not going to score.
James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. The game is still scoreless. Slides that one right across the blue line. Yeah. Looking at something happen in the offensive zone. Puck picked up by LeBlanc. Slides it up front. Some solid defensive work in the road end with the poke check. Canes plays it against the boards. Stalls him in front. Trying to clear. Great defensive effort to keep it here in the offensive end.
So many times. The key is don't lose your confidence in it when it doesn't succeed. Just get right back to the basics. Get the puck to the net and people there at the same time.
Takes that one right in the logo. Bank pass off the boards. Moves the puck along the half wall. Philadelphia's gained possession along the boards. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone. They've got each other down there.
No, they're going to bark at each other on the way to the penalty box, but into the box they go. Time to sit down.
Sturm's ready for the draw as they continue to be shorthanded here. And with the two centers tangled up, the winger skates away with it. Moves it to Timmer.
McKinnon's ready to go.
Attacking zone from the right. That ball goes up, off the side of the net. Oh, great read as he takes it away.
Hart's probably the winner.
Scores! Gabriel Landeskog!
If you're the goalie here, you just want to move as quick as you can. you can. Maybe it'll hit you, but it's so close to the net that passes on the tape and off the tape in a hurry.
Colorado's tenacity finally earns themselves a one-goal lead.
Now be a little cautious. Play like a front runner. You've got the lead. You've worked hard for it.
But the point looks to make something happen.
These late penalties in a period are really crucial. You want to kill this one off so you don't lose any momentum going into the break.
The Flyers send their man advantage unit out once more.
Down to a 4-on-3 with the penalty that they just took. You have to continue to move your feet even though you have a man advantage. Now it's just one man. You got to move around those penalty units.
Can they capitalize on this power play here with a faceoff? The Avs win the faceoff. We've got a penalty coming up here. And that's just out of reach. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
I'm not sure if this is part of the comeback plan, James, but the penalty killers are going to have to do their job and try and waste this penalty away.
Some pushing and shoving here, heating up.
Yeah, the few words lead to a little bit more, it looks like.
Takes a shot, and with just seconds to spare, they get a goal here to close things up.
You gotta look at it from both ways. That's a real kick in the pants for the team that gave up the goal. But what a boost of energy for them to score this late in the period. Wow, that screen looked like it was just about perfect, didn't it? He doesn't even react as this puck goes by him.
The Avalanche have a commanding 2-0 lead. What's the message on the bench here now?
Don't sit back yet. Still try to attack. Still try to push the play. Go get one if you can.
There it is. That's a wrap for period number 2. Both teams will get a chance to get a little breather here, and we'll come back. Third period action next. Drop the puck on period number 3. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's do this. puck leaves the zone, they'll be forced to regroup at center.
Chance to win. You don't want this lingering on too long. Now they fight.
didn't turn it over much at all.
We hear the term puck possession.
Thank you.
are in the scoreless game, these guys can't get off the ice fast enough for their first opportunity.
Picked up along the wall by Hayes, and he makes the save on that play. Passes it over to Taves. The Avs carried along the wall.
On a refresh, we'll get a clean sheet of ice and come back for period number two.
And we are just moments away from the start of period number two.
Possession game that looks a lot better.
shot, though. The goalie bites on it, and he goes to the forehand. Makes no mistake to put it in the net.
Nice job tying up his opponent. The Avs have it behind the net. Here they come up along the wing. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Philadelphia is looking to break out of the burn in. Taken along the wall by Van Riemsdyk. Great use of the stick in the defensive end by Nichushkin.
Away from getting back underway here with the puck drop. Couturier's won the draw. Provorov's hard down. Penalty on the way. Here's the official call. The Avalanche have been penalized. They'll serve two in the box. The Flyers once again send out their power play unit.
And so I like a little bit of patience, but don't just pass the puck around the outside. It's got to get on the inside eventually.
Philadelphia's grabbed a hold of the puck. Picked up along the wall by Konechny. Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. Feeds it down low. Philadelphia's gained possession. Couturier's moving the puck through his own zone. Clearing attempt, and the puck's out of harm's way. And that's intercepted by Philby. Comfer's penalty has expired, but they remain shorthanded as he joins the kill. Good defensive stop at the poke check. Philadelphia's got it from behind the net. The Flyers come up empty-handed on the power play. We're back to even strength here.
Well, when the puck moves and the feet don't, this is what you get. You had lots of zone time, but no real dangerous chances on that power play.
Well past the midway mark of this period, Colorado's got a 3-0 lead. They have been in control right from the start. Tries to get the puck to Manson. Manson's lugging the puck.
goalie's just better on this one.
Come back with the third period next. Welcome back, everyone. He's Ray, I'm James, and we are ready to kickstart this third period. 4 minutes to go here at regulation. It has been a very one-sided affair. Well, we've got two periods under our belts to this point, so what do you see, James?
Philadelphia's been a step slow almost all game. They haven't had the puck very much. They're losing. If that's going to change, they've got to get the puck and roll off.
Just the way they are. But when you haven't been successful, you've got to reload, refocus, and get to work on that next one.
That's the shooter on that play. Hot move over to Copper. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. Great read with the stick. And now it's grabbed by Johnson. There's the whistle. Let's see what the referee saw.
You can almost feel the frustration oozing out of the players here. They're down a bunch, they take another penalty. This can't get over quick enough.
A little 4-on-4 coming up here.
Patience with the puck's a key in 4-on-4. You got more time, don't give the puck away.
The Avs are going to work here in the offensive zone. Can't get it to go. Picked up along the boards by Stern. The Avs will have a chance to go to work here on the man advantage after the penalty expired. And not much on that one. Pokes it away to keep the pressure on.
They sure are running out of gas here, James. This shift is endless. Ellis jumps off. The penalty's almost over.
Taking a look at the ball.
On the power play melts away. They don't get anything on it. I don't think it's particularly important because they've got such a nice lead here. They just want to run the puck.
Steps into the offensive end. Manages to hang on. Rantanen's going to play it from the back of the cage. Makes a move in front. Takes the pass from his goaltender. Grabbed along the boards by Sandheim. And the puck clears the zone. Colorado's got the puck in the defensive end. Unable to reach that one.
Look at the wheels here.
Whoa, he gets going down the ice. Negates the icing call, so no faceoff in their zone.
Here's a chance. Puts him away. Looking to make something happen along the board.
could feel this coming. The pressure of this forecheck, the relentless pursuit of the puck. Eventually, it's either a penalty or a goal. In this case, it's in the net and it's on the board.
Stops the clock on the way to the end of this game.
And the final horn sounds for this one. Greg, what a run between the pipes right now.
The shutout streak continues. It's not just on the goalie, it's the guys in front of him. But he has been red hot.
clean sheet